Good morning, guys. This is kind of a video request. I was asked to show how I make real, authentic Italian coffee. But enough with the chicha, let's get on it. So to make an authentic Italian cup of coffee, you need a few things. First and foremost, none of those fancy Starbucks machines, none of those fancy De'Longhi machine. The only thing you really need is this. This is a mocha, it's made by Bialetti, and Bialetti is the only brand allowed for the mocha itself. They're cheap, I'll put a link in the description. They come in all different sizes. This is actually a keychain, but no, this is a single cup. The second thing you need is authentic Italian coffee, espresso to be exact. This one is Lavazza from Turin in Italy, and this is imported. You can find this thing at all sorts of grocery stores. This is not a rare coffee to find. This is actually pretty easy and is not that expensive. So you need this. Make sure in the back it shows that is for this type of machine. Another important thing to make good coffee is clean, clear water. You cannot use tap water. Doesn't matter where you live, doesn't matter how clean and pure the water comes out of the faucet is. They usually add chlorine or whatever to make it drinkable. Another thing you need, obviously, is a Valentino Rossi shirt on as you're making the coffee. Now, other acceptable MotoGP riders are Dovizioso, Bagnaia, Iannone, Morbidelli, I'm not quite sure, but moving on. Last, very important thing you need to make authentic Italian coffee is you being Italian. As we all know, there are pros and cons on being Italian. Pros, well, my genetic predisposition on making good coffee, even if I never made coffee before coming to the States. Unfortunately, with being Italian, you also have some draws, like I shaved when I woke up this morning. There is a little bit of Italian in everybody. My wife, which is the whitest person I know, one shade less and she'll be transparent. It turns out she has 10% Italian in her. If you have no Italian in you, do not despair. I'm gonna show you exactly what you need to do to have a great cup of coffee, as long as you follow all the other rules. And stay tuned until the end of the video, because a secret step is gonna be revealed. First thing first, don't pay attention to this. This is a decoy for those that don't know the way of making coffee. So let's grab the mocha over here and let's open it up. This is divided in three parts. The one where the actual coffee is gonna end up. The little basket where you need to put the coffee. And the bottom where the water goes. Pay attention to the bottom. This thing is very important. If you look at this, this is like a pressure release type of thing. But there is a portion on the inside as well. And that's exactly where you need to put the water up to. Once you have the water, put it aside because it's time to put coffee in here. The coffee does not need to be pressed in. The coffee needs to be nice and even, and then drop it in there. It is now time to put it together, and it just screws in. There you go. It needs to be tight, but not so tight that when you're done with it, you can't open it back up. It is time to put the mocha on the stove. And there are a few crucial steps. First, Valentino flag on the stove, important. Second, turn the fire on a low setting. Third, keep the top closed. And last but not least, Alexa, play Tarantella.
Italian Tarantella, starting now on Amazon Music.
You need to shut off the gas as soon as it starts doing this. And this is how you make an authentic Italian cup of coffee. I wish you guys could smell this thing, it smells so good. But let's not forget the secret step to make that good of a cup of coffee. And the secret step is Italian tank top, chain, and unshaven chest. So if you like this video, like, if you love this video, subscribe. Check the description below for everything I just used. And because I'm salivating, I'm gonna go drink this coffee. Ride on, and I'll see you next time.